We think prediction is going to get much cheaper. And if prediction gets much cheaper, extraordinary things will happen.
Judgment, at the end of the day, is inherently human. We are the people who understand what matters to us. We're the people who understand what we value. And as long as the machines aren't truly intelligent, right? So as long as it's prediction machines, they're there to serve us in some sense. They're tools. And so it's our job to figure out what matters to us, what to do with those tools. So in a very explicit sense, the machines can't do judgment. It's human. Now, over time with enough data, it's true a machine can learn to predict what a human would judge to do in a particular situation, but then that just moves the judgment up the ladder, and we still need humans to figure out what are those situations we should put ourselves in, what can we use the machines for, and what do at the end of the day we as individuals care about. A lot of what happens in human resources, a lot of what happens in the hiring process is prediction. And so a lot of those steps, moving from posting a job to selecting a candidate, to interview, to actually hiring, are increasingly going to be done at least in collaboration with algorithms. And so we already have that resume screening, that very first step, or I guess the second step. So the first thing you post a job, people apply, and then you screen those resumes. That's increasingly done in a lot of companies by algorithms. The algorithms are fine. They're not as good as they could be, but they're fine. And they're much more efficient than humans, particularly at reading the 387th resume. So when humans go through resumes, they're pretty good for the first 10, but you get to 387 and they're not as good, where the machines are just as good at that one as they are the first one. Privacy, at the regulatory level, you think about government-enforced privacy, that's a statement about restrictions on data flows. And data is the key input into AI, or at least one of the key inputs into AI. And so if you're restricting data flows, you're going to restrict the potential of this technology. Now, again, it's important to emphasize that that might not be a bad thing. If privacy is a right, then it's a right. And there's another subtlety, which is that just because you may, as a society, restrict data flows, which makes your AI worse, maybe that means the really smart people will go into some other science and technology fields, and innovation will happen there. So it's not necessarily a slowing down of overall growth if we have some of these privacy restrictions.
The dissonance between what's happening now and what people are projecting will happen in the future is a statement about how fast we're going to get to, from where we are now, to really, really cheap prediction, how fast that dies.